We'll now hear from the president of the AFC USA, Thanos Dimadis, who is a foreign correspondent here from Greece and a distinguished Knight Badgett Fellow at Columbia Journalism School. He has worked very hard to make this a special evening. He started months ago and has done everything from this room to the caterer to all the organizations. So please join me in a round of applause for Thanos.
Dear esteemed guests, Secretary Johnson, thank you all for your substantial presence here tonight. Your presence signifies something bigger than just attending a social event, because let me be clear, this is not a social event. It is a proof of what can be achieved in a course of a few months when a group of determined people, foreign correspondents who share the same vision, get together, unify their voices, deploy their energy to serve a common mission. And this is not just the mission of advancing the interests of our foreign correspondents community in the United States, but it's also to apply the theory of some of the very recognized Greek philosophers like Plato, Socrates, Aristotle, had about education. Socrates and Plato believe that education is the vehicle to attain knowledge. Aristotle conceived education as not only the attainment of knowledge, but also the attainment of happiness and goodness in life. We at the Association of Foreign Correspondents believe that the success in our profession as foreign journalists can be attained only by strengthening the exposure of us in the multiple resources that this country, the United States of America, offers to all foreigners who have the privilege of living and working in the United States. The financial aid we provide tonight to distinguished foreign journalists to pursue their master's degree in fields relevant to their reporting and to their profession is a bold step towards accomplishing our mission. But as I said, that is only a step. Our ambitions and our work do not start and do not end only with these scholarships. Today, I'm pleased to announce that starting tomorrow, I'm going to submit to our boards my recommendations for how the Association of Foreign Correspondents in 2020 will become the vehicle of also showcasing, advancing, honoring the excellence of work that is done every year by foreign journalists across the globe who work and report the news from the United States back to their own country. We are living in an historical period where it's not enough just to detect the problem and develop nice speeches describing this problem, because the problem is known to everyone almost in this room. The disruption of traditional media from the technology, from the traditional media organizations, from the technology, the difficulties that public institutions and tech giants like Facebook, Google, Twitter are facing on placing restrictions against misinformation and propaganda. The bullying and intimidation against journalists from authoritarian regimes and governments from across the globe that are synonymous to attacks against the core principles of our democracies, such as the need for free expression and the need for an informed public. And I would like to give an example and a sense of what is happening in Greece, since everyone here spoke about their own countries. In Greece, in order to be a successful journalist, you need to be aligned with the interests of the government. Everyone here spoke about the, you know, propaganda. I would say that there is another form of journalism that we need to denounce here, which is the partisan journalism. The journalism that serves the interests, not the interest of the public, to inform the public, but the interests of specific governments, political parties, In Greece, we have the examples of journalists who are running their own media organizations, news websites, and they say that they are independent, but they are not, because they are receiving advertisements from the governmental officials. And they are accountable to these governmental officials of how they diffuse the information. We have the example of journalists who are expressing public opinion in TVs, radio shows, and at the same time they are serving in the political office of a minister. We have the example of journalists who are intimidated by their own directors of news, because when they are trying to say something against the government, but because this is the truth of their reporting, they are just turned down and they don't progress their careers. These are regular daily examples that we need to face. It's not enough to talk about only fake news, misinformation, propaganda. We need, on the one hand, to support those journalists who need our support of doing their work with integrity and independence, and on the other side, to isolate the examples of those journalists who are at the same time getting money, being payrolled, getting paid by governmental executives to diffuse specific information in favor of those who are getting paid. This cannot be accepted anymore. Thank you. So, concluding my remarks, I would say that I believe that the fate of our profession is in our hands. Also, the responsibility to protect our dignity, our independence, our integrity, and our profession is in our shoulders. We cannot win this fight unless we, all journalists from different levels, local journalists, national journalists, international journalists, work together and get organized through unions and organizations that can ensure the fair and bold representation of us. That's why the only way to make our voices heard is through the existence of the organizations like the Association of Foreign Correspondents, like many other organizations, like the United Nations Correspondents Association, like the Overseas Press Club, like the Committee to Protect Journalists. We need to support these organizations. We are not competitive with each other. We are standing on the same side of the history with all these organizations together. On behalf of the Association of Foreign Correspondents, I want to thank you, our supporters, for the private sector, for their generous contributions. Specifically, I want to thank you, Ray Kerins, Chris Loder from Bayer, thank you. Peter Dobro from Microsoft, who is not here today, Damon Jones from P&G, as well as the teams from CBS, NASDAQ. And this is a thank you not only for their generous contributions, Chris, Ray, Peter, and many other people who represent these corporations, but it is a thank you because their support comes with nothing in exchange. And I want to highlight this, because their contributions are unconditional. And this allows the independence and the integrity of our organization. And I want to make that clear and to be fully transparent of who are the supporters, who are the sponsors, who are the contributors to our organization. We have nothing to hide. We are more than transparent here. And before concluding, I want to thank personally all those people who are serving on the boards of the Association of Foreign Correspondents, that I will say their names and I would like them to stand up to just to meet them, because they are here, but they give, first of all, their reputation, their credibility, their names, their work, and they dedicate these things to our organization. I want to thank you, Nancy Prager-Kamel, our chairwoman. Please stand up. Suzanne Modares, our vice president. Clarissa McNera, our deputy vice president. Alan Jude-Riland, our general secretary. Manoj Rizal from Nepal, our treasurer. Laura Haim, who made the honor to us to be here today from DC. Laura, please. Betul Yuruk from Turkey, and we are neighbors. Where is Betul?
I think she left.
Okay, she left, but it's fine. She had another commitment. Betul Yuruk works for Anatolia Agency based on the United Nations. People working from the United Nations, covering the United Nations, are extremely busy. And Suzanne Modares, Valeria Robeco knows that. Serwin, the former president of the United Nations Correspondence Association, who is here today, and thank you, knows that very well. Momo Eban from Nikkei. Bobby Taluktar, who is not here today. Alan Teknon from Africa. Thank you, Alan. Alexander Hassanin, who is also covering the United Nations for Japanese newspapers. Thank you, Alexander. Elena Lenza, who is not here tonight, unfortunately, she's from Portugal. Jane Issei, our member of our educational board of directors. Jane, come please, of course. We have to have you here. Helen Whitney, who worked very hard also to review all these applications, and I was telling them, please give me the 10 names so you can select the 5 first names. And they reviewed all these applications, and not only that, Marilyn Haft, Lina Tabori, please come here, contacted all these universities in order to spread the word about our applications, because the real challenge here for those who are not aware, and also for our supporters and sponsors and donors, is how to make people aware that we provide scholarships. And Thomas Barat from Hungary. Thank you, Thomas. Who has written 17 books in Hungary, and he has been a distinguished professor of journalism and communications. Monique Tapi, unfortunately, she didn't make it tonight. She was not able. I want to thank you also, our advisors, Chris Loder. Thank you for being with us. Maiv Duvali from Goldman Sachs. Maiv. Thank you. Amelia Augustus, who has been one of the founders and very prominent supporters of the Knight Budget Fellowship Program at Columbia Journalism School. And she, during her career, she fought really hard to make women, to bring women in the epicenter of decision making and of public affairs. And I also want to thank you, Robert Clauser, Darius Grant, and all of our advisors who are not here tonight. Cecil McCarthy, of course, because without her, we wouldn't be here tonight. And really, thank you. Thank you very much for having appointed me and for having trusted me on serving as president of the Association of Foreign Correspondents. Thank you. Down Kissy also. She just came. Please join our, please.